The Malolos Regional Trial Court acquits retired Major General Jovito Palparan Jr. in the kidnapping case filed by brothers Raymond and Reynaldo Manalo. Our correspondent Vivienne Gulia joins us on the line for more. Viv.
Hi, Ron. A Malolo City Regional Trial Court has acquitted retired Major General Jovito Palparan Jr. and three others accused in the kidnapping and torture of brothers Raymond and Reynaldo Manalo in 2006 and 2007. Malolos RTC Branch 19 presiding judge Francisco Feliz Meño dismissed this Friday the charges of kidnapping and serious illegal detention with serious physical injuries against Palparan and Tafco auxiliaries Michael de la Cruz, Marcelo de la Cruz, and Maximo de la Cruz on the ground of reasonable doubt. The court said it saw inconsistencies in the statement of the prosecution's lone witness, Raymond, regarding some details related to his experiences when he was kidnapped and detained. The court further noted that Raymond did not show a high level of certainty when he identified Palparan as a perpetrator and that his degree of attention was, quote, questionable. It expressed doubts whether the complainant had a good opportunity to view the perpetrator in a dark basketball court in Barangay Sapang, San Miguel, Bulacan, where they supposedly met between midnight and 3 o'clock in the morning. It said that doubt exists not on the fact that the crime happened, but rather on the identity of the accused. The court also said that the prosecution failed to prove beyond reasonable doubt the alleged conspiracy between Palparan and the three other accused. Complainant Raymond Manalo is a surviving witness victim in the kidnapping of UP students Sherlyn Cadapan and Karen Empeño in 2006. After the promulgation, Manalo was seen bursting into tears as he left the courtroom. He was hugged by supporters who waited outside the building. Raymond admitted that he was deeply hurt by the unfavorable decision of the court, but he noted that he will continue to seek justice for himself and for others who suffered human rights. Here is a portion of his statement.
Yun nga eh, kaya nga sobrang sakit para sa akin yun. Dahil sa lahat naman ng kaso na ipinail naman ng Kadapan ni Peño, halos pinaniwalaan ko ng mataas na korte. Pagdating dito sa RTC ng Branch 19, inakakapagtaka bakit nyo i-acquit. At siyempre, hindi rin ko pinipaniwala. Dahil kanina, nung binabasa nila yung kuan, eh, nagtaka ako. Bakit 2017 kami nagkaharap ni Palparan? 2007 kami nag-meet. Nagkakaroon sila ng ibang mga date.
Ano na ang plano mo ngayon?
Eh, kagaya nga nito, eh, para sa akin, eh, kung ano yung magpag-uusapan namin, eh, tuloy ang laban. Hindi ako titigil, hindi ako susuko hanggang hindi ko nakakamit ang tunay ng sisa para sa akin, para sa ibang mga kasamahan ko, mga nalabagang karapatang pagtaan.
In a statement, National Union of People's Lawyers Chairperson Edrey Olalia said the ruling was, quote, simply unbelievable, if not disturbingly shocking. Labeled as a butcher by activists, Palparan was a star in the anti-communist drive called Oplan Bantaylaya under then-President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. In 2018, Palparan was convicted of kidnapping and serious illegal detention for the disappearance of Cadapan and Empeño. Ron, back to you.
Viv, just one question. What happens to Palparan now? Will he be set free?
Well, according to the decision of the court, there is an order to immediately release Major General Jovito Palparan Jr. from detention unless he is being lawfully held for another cause. And that cause is this decision convicting him of the kidnapping and serious illegal detention for the disappearance of Cadapan and Empeño. He was sentenced with reclusion perpetua.
Thanks for that. Go ahead, Viv.
That's it, Ron. Back to you.
Okay, thank you very much, Vivienne Gulia. The UP Journalism Media and Information Literacy Project kicks off today with a focus on fact-checking. We have more on that story from our correspondent, Anjo Bagawisan. Anjo?
Hi, Ron. It's a valuable media literacy resource for schools, students, and the public. This was how Journalists and Educators Law did the release of the University of the Philippines project that aims to aid the teaching of media and information literacy in schools all over the country. The project brought together 9 veteran journalists from 2 leading Philippine organizations or Philippine news organizations, including ABS-CBN News' own Carmina Constantino, Jeff Canoy, and Zen Hernandez, as well as GMA integrated news personalities like Howie Severino, Connie Sison, and Atom Araulio. Over the coming weeks, instructional videos presented by these journalists will be uploaded to the project's YouTube channel with free access for all. While media and information literacy has been taught as a subject in senior high school since 2017, a study by the UP Journalism Department found that teachers lack the resources and training to competently teach the subject. Some teachers also lamented the students' lack of comprehension and even apathy towards monitoring the news. UP Journalism Department Chair and broadcast journalist Kava David said the videos are their contribution to bridging that gap and raising media literacy in an environment plagued by disinformation and the rise of artificial intelligence. Aside from understanding how the news is produced, the videos, which were written by journalism students, will also give practical instructions on how to fact-check information found in social media. These videos can be accessed on the YouTube channel at UPJourndepth. UP journalism professors also developed a learning module and quizzes to accompany the videos, which they can show during their classes. Ron, back to you.
Anjo, thanks for that story. The Philippine government boosting efforts to enhance cybersecurity. The Justice Department says it will tap over 1,000 additional prosecutors. The agency is also deploying hundreds of prosecution attorneys. Now, this move from the DOJ comes after the Philippine National Police reported cybercrime cases in Metro Manila rose 152% in the first half of the year.